Hi, and welcome to the Ask Dr. Angela podcast with everyone's favorite OBGYN, Dr. Angela Jones. Have you ever been too embarrassed or shy to ask your own doctor about your, you know, girl parts? Well, you've come to the right place to get straight answers. Feel free to ask Dr. Angela anything women's health related. Obstetrics and gynecology? She keeps it real. Pregnancy? She's been there, done that. Menopause? She'll get you through. Young or old, Dr. Angela's got you covered, girl. Now here's Dr. Angela.
What's good, people? This is Dr. Angela, everyone's favorite OBGYN, and I would like to officially welcome you to episode 290 of the Ask Dr. Angela podcast. It's a good day to be alive. You ever just wake up and think that? I do. One of the first things that I always do when I wake up in the morning, once I do open my eyes, even before I open my eyes, but I'm just lying in bed and awake, even if my eyes are still closed, I do my daily meditation and I just practice expressions of gratitude. Thank you for my life. Thank you for my job. Thank you for my family. Thank you for being able to wake up this morning and do what I do and be who I am. I always try to practice gratitude. I try to preach gratitude to my many. It really helps to kind of keep things in perspective. I speak with my dad on a daily basis. I usually talk to him en route to either office hours or en route to the hospital. And whenever, you know, I'm a bit disgruntled or things aren't quite going as I would like them to in my realm, you know, my dad always says to me, well, you know what, Ange, how about you woke up this morning? How about you have a car to drive to work? How about you have your health, your vision, you know, all of these things that we take for granted. So I really try to focus on the little things, which in the big scheme of things are actually really big things. So kind of in keeping with my last podcast where, you know, everyone was asking me, oh my gosh, could I be pregnant? The other very common query that I get from all over the world, and not just from women, but from guys too. Either who's the daddy or am I the daddy? And I get from the woman's perspective a lot of emails, you know, telling me when their period was and when they had sex and when they had sex again with a different partner. And again, first thing that comes to mind for me is if we are concerned about pregnancies, unintended pregnancy specifically, contraception becomes really important. And, you know, there's never any judgment. You know, we are who we are. We do what we do. And that's fine, to each his or her own. But when it comes to being able to determine who the father is and you've had sex with multiple partners around the time of ovulation, it's anybody's baby. And I guess I say that to say it's anybody's guess. The one thing that I do know about sperm is that, and this is probably the take home of this podcast, is that sperm can survive, per most literature, for up to 5 days in the female reproductive tract. So, you know, based on that fact alone, it's going to be hard to know who the daddy is, specifically if you have been with multiple partners around the time of your ovulation. You know, whenever I hear who's the daddy, I always think of Maury Povich. I mean, who hasn't seen Maury Povich when, you know, he brings those dads out, you know, with the moms? And, you know, it's usually kind of an angry show. It's, you know, a lot of anger in Maury Povich's show, but that's neither here nor there. And then he has that envelope and he says, you are not the father, or he says, and you are the father. It just kind of cracks me up. So, you know, for those of you who are sending me all these queries, the one thing that I love is that you trust me enough to send these questions to me. And I always tell people there are never any dumb questions, because I guarantee you what you ask, someone else was afraid to ask. And if you thought it and you're asking, trust me, someone else thought the same thing. They just didn't reach out. So thank you so much for always, you know, sending these questions. I don't think that any of them are ridiculous or dumb or anything like that. And I'm always happy to address them. So to my ladies out there, if, you know, you're concerned about paternity, take out, you know, the guessing and either use protection or, you know, entertain monogamy. Just saying, But the other thing is, you know, for those of us who are not interested in being parents at any given time, contraception is a must. And again, I can't reiterate safe sex more because it's like super important, especially with STIs being on the rise. I mean, they're like through the roof. So just be safe. And, you know, that's probably, you know, it for this query. You know who the dad is by either practicing safer sex or practicing monogamy. Those are my two thoughts on that. So hopefully this podcast, though brief and pretty simple, hopefully it has helped someone out. And just good luck for those of you who are in this situation and you're not quite sure about paternity. Just good luck in all things. As is the huge, I want to thank you so much for tuning into this podcast. Thank you for all the love, the support, the shout outs. I appreciate it so much. If you have a question or a concern that you want featured on the podcast, you know what to do. You can reach me at www.askdrangela.com. That's askdrangela.com. And you can send me an email. You can send me a direct message through any of my social media venues. And please sign up for the blog that goes out weekly. They're funny as hell, and they're also very informative. Please sign up for the podcast, which I continue to be amazed by the reach of the podcast. You know, people are actually listening to little old me, but I guess I do kind of have a lot to say. So, you know, keep those questions, those queries coming. And please, please, please keep your eyes peeled for my pregnancy book, which will be released on April 9th. And a huge thank you to all of you that signed up to preview it prior to its release. I appreciate it more than you know. And so, as is the usual, I'm going to leave you with some pearls. This one's coming to you from one of my favorites, Life's Little Instruction Book. It's a little plaid red book that I love. And today's lesson says, it's number 213. Don't waste time grieving over past mistakes. Learn from them and move on. You know, there's a lot of wisdom in this little statement. You know, learn the lesson and move on. Because what I do know, and this is from experience, is that when we don't learn the lesson, different scenarios and situations will represent themselves until you learn the lesson. So learn the lesson and save yourself a lot of heartache and drama and, you know, everything else that goes along with those things. So until next time, look better, feel better, be better. Can't wait to tune in. Or I can't wait for you to tune in on episode 291 of the Ask Dr. Angela podcast.
Thank you for listening to the Ask Dr. Angela podcast. For more information on women's health and the show notes for this episode, please visit Dr. Angela at www.askdrangela.com. While you're there, don't forget to leave your own message for Dr. Angela. See you soon. All of the information provided and discussed in this podcast is for educational and informational purposes only and should not take the place of consulting a physician. This podcast is not intended to diagnose, treat, or cure any disease or illness and does not and should not replace treatment from a medical professional.